Hello everyone, my name is Masbaba Charles and welcome back to another Apostles of Muchinjikwa podcast. We hope that the previous podcasts have been of some help to you and they've been of benefit in your journey to getting closer to God. For this week, the topic that we wish to discuss is one that is always repeated by the Holy Spirit. It is always saying that let those who want to be saved be saved. And let those that don't, won't. So the Holy Spirit is saying that it is your choice whether you want to be saved. In Shona it is said that anoda kupona ndaapone, asingade ndaarege. It is your choice whether you want to listen to the words of the Holy Spirit. It is your choice whether you want to believe in what you see in Masowe. It is your choice whether you want to have faith of what you hear and what you yourself has witnessed. There is a lot of stuff that you hear that people say other people are faking, other people are doing this, but from what I have seen and what I have heard in Masowe, there is a Holy Spirit, a true Holy Spirit that other people might just not be able to appreciate or to recognize unless they have actually been in there themselves. And just like in other churches, you see corruption somewhere along the line, but truly the Holy Spirit is there. And this is evidence that if you look at so many people that come into Masowe, if you look at Masowe, it is not the most attractive of religions. It is not. You have people who wear plain white clothing, who just sit on the floor in the scorching heat and in bad weather, in the rain, in every storm, they'll be outside and they will be just praying. It's a religion where people will be ridiculed because they'll be seen as that they are not educated or that they do not know what they are doing, because otherwise who in their right mind would be sitting on the floor in the heat and say that they're just worshipping God? But there is something that is hidden in Masowe that people do not know. It is an unpolished gem that people don't realize that they are sitting on. And this is something that I just wish to be able to help people in order to better understand and to help people in order to discover what Masowe is all about. So like I said, it is a choice. And if you look at the millions of apostles that are scattered all around in Africa, there is a reason why it is so. There is a reason, because the Holy Spirit speaks with us. You always hear the phrase that in other religions you get people that they read from the Bible and they read from the Holy Scriptures or any of the holy books of the history that was done. But in Masowe, what we get is live and direct, because what is not about what was done, but it is what is being done. It's not about what was said, but it is what is being said and the works of the Holy Spirit that is happening right now as we speak. So it is this stuff that calls so many people in order to come. That's why we have so many followers, thousands and thousands of followers who follow this wave, raging all the way from highest education to lowest education. You have everyone in there, because there's something that they've seen when it comes into Masowe. There's something that they are able to appreciate. So it was this that I just wish people, in order to have a better understanding of what it means when they come to Masowe, of what it means when what they're searching for when they come to Masowe, that you are looking for your salvation, you are looking in order for you to be saved, and there is something that is in Masowe that is able to save you, because there is a speaking with the Holy Spirit, there's a way that you can communicate with your Father, there is a way that your answers that you're seeking for can be given to you. Just how in the days of Peter and in the days of Paul, that people would come to them and they would say, what is it that God is saying? What is it that we need to do? And Masowe is able to give you this kind of questions. I remember back in the year about 2001, when the Holy Spirit had just first started this mission and was doing its works, and it was in Zimbabwe, and it said to them that there's a message that I have been given. so that your people might know that I have been sent by God. And it wants you to all come together because there is a mission that we have to do and there's stuff that need to be done. And people did not listen in that time. And so what the Holy Spirit did, the Holy Spirit came and he said to someone, can you go get me what they call maputi? And in Zimbabwe, maputi is just like corn that's been popped up and then is sprinkled. There has a lot of salt in it. And the Holy Spirit tipped all the contents that was in the bag and was left was the salt that was in there. And the Holy Spirit said, because of what you have done and you have refused me, I shall show you. And in the next 7 years, there shall be suffering in Zimbabwe. And you, even this salt that you look for, this salt that is so precious to you and very common to you, you shall struggle to find it. There shall be hardship in those years. And you shall know it's because that you have refused me. And the Holy Spirit said this, and people did not believe, and they laughed, and they said, how is it Zimbabwe in salt? It's found commonly, even a child can have salt. It's nothing. But truly, over those years, until about 2008, people suffered, and people went through a lot. But it was stuff that had been prophesied by the Holy Spirit already, and it was stuff that had already been said. So you see, these are the kind of gems that you can find in Masowe. For the Holy Spirit will tell you that where you are going, it's going to be like this, it's going to be like this, it's going to be like this. We had prophecies that the Holy Spirit would tell you, such as one that I said of the baboon that walked in Harare. The Holy Spirit would tell us there was the births of children, that the Holy Spirit would tell us that, oh, I see that you have a child that's going to be born, but do you know that your child is going to be a son or a daughter? And even in some cases, you'd get people who said that, I've always had girls and the doctors are saying that I'm going to have another girl, but please, I want a boy child now. And the Holy Spirit would be, are you sure of what you asked me? And the person would be like, yes. And then the Holy Spirit would do a prayer, and then miraculously, when that child is born as a boy, instead of a girl, as what was seen by the doctors, which is just some of the works that you find in Masowe. And this is why I say I have not come to justify Masowe. I have not come in order for people to try to get you to believe, but I'm trying to get you to understand Masowe, that there is something hidden. If you can just come to try to dig just a little bit deeper. Do not listen straight away to the myths that people try to tell you that Masowe is like this or Masowe is like this. So we're trying to get you to understand from our own perspective because of the things that we have seen and the stuff that we have heard from the Holy Spirit, that we are not poor, but we are rich. For we are rich within the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is giving us so much more than what is out there in the world. So when you see us sitting on that floor, it does not mean that we have nothing for us to take off our shoes and to sit on the floor. But it means we have so much that the wealth that's been put on our shoulders is so heavy to carry that we sit on the floor and we just appreciate what God has given to us. And I tell you this because I feel that I am truly blessed. Because without Masowe, I do not think that many of us could have been saved, because so many of us had been so far gone. But Masowe was able to call us again. You get people who were drunks and they were called by the Holy Spirit and it completely transformed their lives. And this is the beauty that I find in Masowe. I'll give you a short story before I finish. And one of the leaders in Masowe, when the Holy Spirit first descended upon him, he was someone who was drunk. And the Holy Spirit chose to him. And while he was there, the Holy Spirit started speaking and he said, I'm going to send you and I want you to go to a mountain. And when you go to those mountains, I want you to tell these people that I have sent you and their answer, that what they've been praying for has been answered. And you shall be the one that is going to carry on these works. And so the Holy Spirit in Masowe has saved people who were in the most unfortunate of circumstances. People who by society were seen as lost and could never be found again. But the Holy Spirit in Masowe has been able to call these people once again. And he has called them and it has saved them. It is truly the salvation of so many. It is truly the calling of many that have been lost. that have been told to come back and to hear the voice that is calling wild and the voice that is in the wilderness that is calling for people to come back again to God. And this is why I'm happy and this is why I'm proud. And I wish that other people could just take a little bit of time in order to digest and to understand of what is Masowe. And so it is with that that I hope that I've been able to give you a bit of help into your understanding of Masowe and why it is that we are so much faithful in believing what we believe and how we act the way that we act. And I hope that this podcast has been of some help to you, to help to clarify your own understanding of Masowe. And with that, I say glory be to God.